Going to the doctor. A little ear. Liquid Death, shout out Liquid Death. Sent me some new cans.
Oh, that's cold.
It's been pretty busy so far. It is fucking Thursday, January 21st, 11:33 a.m. Feeling crazy and alive and out here doing the damn thing. Waiting for the world to just figure out what's happening. And I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet for February, if I'm going to go out of town yet or not, because it's just so hard to plan things right now. So, obviously been in the gym, like the program I started with Lane Norton. It's like the last week. I accidentally repeated last week's, or it should have already been over. But anyway, clearly we have a new president of the United States, so everyone is distracted with their political findings. I, this week, have tried to learn more about non-fungible tokens. People are selling art basically on the blockchain. If you don't know what I'm talking about, and you're like, Teddy, what the fuck are you talking about? Just, you know, back in the day, we never saw Netflix coming. Stream a movie, what the fuck are you talking about? We could not see that on the horizon. And that's the way I feel with some of this stuff. I just want to learn new things and, you know, where things are going. Obviously not gonna sit around and argue with people about their opinions on politics, you know. Especially while, you know, the people in power's children are wearing $10,000 sneakers or whatever. So, anyway, not the point. You know, you do you, you know? Obviously been drawing, painting, doing a bunch of bears. People are asking to buy the bear stacks. I get a lot of DMs about the bear stacks. Right now, they're not for sale. They will eventually be for sale, but I think I've said it here. I just want to build a collection of them first, and then I'll sell them because I don't want to have them all. But as I'm making them, it's harder to like want to part with them. Probably going to start on my website this year, putting up paintings just randomly that for sale. The more that I create art, tangible art, like paintings and shit, the more it'll just go direct to my website. Just to get into it, so everybody, you know, everybody here pretty much, well, maybe not, because some of you may be finding this for the first time. Hello, I'm an artist. I don't really like calling myself an artist, but I am. That's what I do. I make art for a living. Mostly clothes. Paintings, tattoos, and clothing is like the main three. And as an artist, you know, you don't want to be, or as anybody really, you don't want to be left behind on new ways that you can make money off your art, because let's just face it, like, it's not the easiest thing. You know, people don't reward artists the way they reward doctors. You know, if your doctor had to have four jobs, you'd probably feel some kind of way about it. What we could be moving into is some sort of renaissance as a intersection between real life art and digital art. I'm gonna try and break this down so simple so that people can understand it. What I'm talking about are called NFTs. They're called non-fungible tokens. NFT. Remember this. Now, all of this lives on a blockchain. You've heard blockchain because of cryptocurrency. I'm going to get to explaining all that to you in a very quick, short, and understandable, hopefully, way. But let's start with NFTs. Non-fungible token. Fungible means something can be exchanged for the same exact value. Like $1 for $1 is fungible. You know, it's a fungible, even $1 for $4, it's fungible. It's the same thing, it equals the same thing. Now, a non-fungible item is something that has a unique property to it for whatever reason. A story, fucking, I don't know, like a Drake t-shirt. Everyone's got the same goddamn Drake t-shirt, but one is signed by Drake, then the one signed by Drake is non-fungible because it's different than the other ones. If one was worn by Drake, non-fungible because it has a different story. It was thrown out to the crowd. Non-fungible. You cannot exchange the one that came from Drake's frail body to the crowd for the one from the merch booth. A non-fungible item is a unique item. And then as far as a token, that is a digital certificate. It's not like an actual token. They call it a token. What essentially non-fungible tokens are digital artifacts or digital collectibles. So the things that we collect now, paintings, baseball cards, all kinds of shit. Those are the first two that come to mind, but paintings and baseball cards, and that's where I'm gonna get to. But there's these things that we collect in the real world. Like when you buy a painting, you can hang it on the wall and you understand that value. And what we're talking about is buying a painting online only. Like the original is just online. It's the digital original. So what you have to break your mind around, because the first thing that everyone's gonna say is, well, that doesn't make sense. Why am I gonna pay for a digital painting when I can right click it and save it and have it? Because you don't have it. You don't actually own the original. There's no record of you owning that original. And there's no record from the artist. There's no record from when the entire project, the painting or the card or whatever began. So you don't actually own it. And granted, this creates you understanding that this is a new market that doesn't exist really. Well, the painting market exists online because paintings are selling for a fuckload of money. The guy who made a painting in real life, the painting through an app basically, made four animations. The moral of the story is the main animation, like the new unique animation that was made from creating the three other prints, sold for $55,500. Just the animation. Now that's just buy it online, you save it to your computer, and you now own the original piece of art animation. It's right there for you. And you can show it to other people. Other people can see it. Other people can watch it. But it says that you own it. So that's your ownership. And that's where the flex is. The flex is in ownership. People don't understand that because most of us are going to go, well, I want to be able to put it on the wall, this, that, and the third. So try to wrap your mind around baseball cards for a second. People buy baseball or sports cards for a lot of money. They don't really put it on the wall. They just put it kind of in a folder somewhere and put it away. That's kind of how you have to think of this. Like everything's online right now. And we don't have a place like the Oasis to go to hang our paintings yet. So you've got to kind of look ahead a little bit and think about in the future, in a Ready Player One environment, you know, these types of things will be valuable to people. And most people are saying and thinking that they will. There's also benefits to digital art. It can't be destroyed. The Sistine Chapel and other paintings you can't even see anymore. There's tons and tons of art, you know, that's been destroyed and is in ruins. So in the physical form, one argument is that digital art is in some way superior because it can't be destroyed. But, you know, this is a hard bridge to cross even for me because I appreciate tangible physical art more than anything, but this is happening. I mean, we can sit here and deny it all we want and say it's stupid, I don't understand it, this, that, and the third, but it's happening. It's just like resale, regular baseball cards, all this stuff. It is happening. So there are these websites you can get on, Super Rare, Rarible, quite a few different places you can go buy or set up shop and whatever. Basically, if I have a picture online that everybody downloads like normal, you know, you put it on their homepage without any permission, and that's cool, it's whatever, you don't own it. And that's what this is really about, is like, who owns the original piece of artwork? As an artist, you create something digitally, you put it online, and then it just spreads out. So it's really trying to keep track of like, okay, who owns this? You know, who created it, and who bought it, and where is it going? That's the purpose of a non-fungible token. Now, the art is one non-fungible token. Sports cards, this new thing that you may have heard of, because it's all the rage this week, which is what got my interest back, kind of like looped back around on this big loop. But yeah, this new thing, NBA Top Shot, which is basically buying digital sports cards online in packs, opening packs, and getting what are called moment, which are basically sports clips, you know, highlights, collecting them like cards and selling them, selling and trading them. And there's different levels, like when you open a fucking Fortnite chest, you know, there's common, rare, superior, whatever the fuck, you know, like legendary, whatever. This is the idea. And when I first heard this, I was like, this doesn't make any sense, right? This doesn't make any sense. All these interviews and videos that I watched and everything, when they ask youth if they feel like they own something like a Fortnite skin, when you ask a kid, like, do you feel like you own that? The answer that they give most of the time is yes. The problem is you can't take that item, like you can't take your Fortnite item out of Fortnite. You can't take it and put it on your character in Mario Kart. You know, you can't take it and put it in NBA 2K. And the idea of this, which I believe will be the future, is that you can take items from real world, digital world, and apply them across all these different places, like all these different games you might play, social places that you hang out, basically your identity, like your online identity. You want to wear Jordans on your character at all times. You know, picture Ready Player One, like the dude have an avatar and they went in and out of games. He didn't change forms when he went into a new game. He was his own character. That's kind of like what we're headed towards, where you'll have an online avatar that will enter all of these things, my belief. That's why you have companies like Nike, who already have patents on some of this shit. They're gonna release shoes in-game, guaranteed. Shoes you can only get in-game. Shoes that you could get in-game, then qualify you for a real-life purchase. Crazy. Like, mind-blowing when you really stop and think about it and the possibilities. Like, it's fucking mind-blowing. And the sports cards, I mean, they're going crazy. I mean, they're going crazy. And it's, you know, again, it's a new thing. It's hype. Everybody's rushing towards it, and who knows? The sport cards part is interesting to me in a way, but it really just reinforces that this is a new technology. A lot like any new technology that we, you know, like 5 years after it's implemented, we're like, no shit. One of one skin that can, you know, be used in game. Like, one person has it. One person. So it's like this rarity, and this is what's going to create this demand, is having these things in game that other people don't have. I mean, how many people grind and grind and grind at Call of Duty to get guns that are special skins before anybody else? You know, CSGO, I think a skin just sold for 150K. You know, we are at the intersection of this, and it is happening. So I'm just paying attention and I'm trying to explain it to you so you understand. Non-fungible token is just like anything else you collect in the world that you're worried about not being real. It can be verified. Samsung is selling digital land. Louis Vuitton, their handbags are getting on the blockchain, where literally traces from what fucking alligator to where it was made, who made it, who the first person to buy it, and who the next girlfriend to get it was. It's crazy the shit that is possible, but this is what we desire. I mean, this is why places like StockX exist, which, if you ask me, will become obsolete with a system like blockchain. So, what is blockchain, you ask? Blockchain is basically the environment that allows this to happen. Picture blockchain as the society, the perfect society, the honest society. It is literally a chain of blocks, and each block holds information. It holds data, and it holds a hash, and then it also holds a previous hash. So it has history. There's a change, or transfer, or sale, or whatever the fucking case may be. A new block is created. The first block doesn't have the previous hash because there is no previous hash. But then the next one will tell you the history. Like, this was the previous hash. This is the hash now. And this is the data. And the next block will, you know, continue on to continue to tell you the story of the history of whatever it is that we're talking about. So say it's a painting, you can see who made it, when they made it, when it was created. And this is all verified because there's an open ledger that everyone has access to. Everyone is constantly verifying this information. So for this to become fraudulent or tampered, you would have to literally change information on every single block and change the proof of work. All of it's not possible. So it's basically like a checks and balances, because there's so many people that are like able to see what's happening, that everyone is constantly verifying the information so that there can be no fraud. It's really incredible when you think about it. Like, when you really wrap your mind around it, it's really incredible. Like, digitally witnessing the creation of art, like, you digitally witness this creation, and then there's data and proof to show that everyone was there when it was created. So there's no dispute. Like, no one can say, no, I made that. It's like, no, this was created by this person on this day, and this is all the verification to show where it came from and where it's been. The one pitfall of selling art now is that you don't get anything on the resale. The term starving artist comes from the fact that most artists are get paid the least for their work, and then later it becomes worth more money, and other people make more money. People invest in artists, which, as an artist, we're asking you to invest in us, so it's been an okay trade-off. But, you know, when you hear about a painting of yours selling for, you know, thousands or millions of dollars, I've never experienced that one, but millions of dollars more than what you sold it for, it doesn't really incentivize you to continue to make work. You know, everybody needs the financial security, and artists definitely need financial security to continue to create, because it takes time. One really cool thing, and one really, really big appeal to this NFTs are, but there's also a commission that is built in to the future sale. So, you know, 10% is what I've seen mostly, but you sell a painting, every time that painting gets resold in the aftermarket, you as the artist get 10%. So as the art grows, as your popularity grows, you're still reaping the benefits of your early work. People are getting turned on to you. You're able to sell more art. It's really like a really good system. The only thing that people have to wrap their brains around is the idea that paintings don't necessarily live on the wall, and they live in the computer, which is a hard thing. I mean, you could display it on your screens. You could obviously display it on your screen, your TV, whatever, but I could also, you know, like I could take basically for the most part, whatever it is, save it somehow and display it, but I don't own it. And the ownership is what really matters. Art and things like that, it's an investment, and it really just comes down to how do you enjoy it. You know, a lot of people enjoy art by hanging it on the wall and looking at it, but we're living every day more and more in a digital age. And who's to say that we won't be going to digital galleries? Who's to say that we won't be going to online businesses that our friends open? Your friend might have an online coffee shop with your other friend's art hanging inside of it, and you go there, not physically, but digitally, and commerce takes place. Yeah, pretty interesting stuff. Like, I just wanted to share it because, you know, like, I spend my time creating stuff, and this week we didn't really go anywhere. I tattooed a lot, but for most of this week, this is what I studied. This is what I looked into. I'm gonna definitely put some stuff in this space because I feel like it is the future, and I feel like the more artists do this, the more it will evolve, and I definitely want to be one of the early-ish adopters to it because I believe in it, and I think it's cool, especially now that I understand it, which it took me, again, a long time to wrap my head around it. You've just got to understand that we already value things online that we can't physically touch. And at one point, we could not imagine buying music where you didn't get a physical album. Like, I remember being like, why would I pay and not get the physical? Why should it cost money if there's no physical album? Like, that was the whole mind process behind downloading music illegally. It was like, well, I'm not stealing because there's no physical anything. It's just a file, like whatever. Not now, we know that doesn't make sense, but at the time, me and many others could not grasp it. So, pretty interesting shit. I mean, even sports cards, like, sport cards have boomed, you know what I mean? But those analog versions of cards might not be the future. NBA Top Shot, whatever the fuck it's called, you know, there's rumors that it's going to turn into a game, like Magic or Pokemon or fucking Dungeons and Dragons or whatever. I don't know, I don't play any of those games, but I do know that, you know, they have these sort of role-played games where it's like, okay, you need a dunk, and then you have this video clip dunk to compete or to put into your contest that you're playing. Shit. So it's fucking crazy, man. It's crazy shit. You should look into it. If you're an artist, I urge you to really look into it and think about it. Try not to be closed-minded because it is so different than what you're used to. I know, me too. Like, literally just like, what the fuck? But when you hear about someone selling a copy of their painting for $55,500, like a digital animation, and the original itself, which is a physical tangible good, sells for $500 less after the fact, like after someone misses out on the digital copy, they go buy the original for 50K, you start to look at the environment it creates for an artist, and it just seems like, why not? Like, what harm is it gonna do you by doing this? Nifty is another one. Nifty is a big one that I'm trying to get in on, and it's something Makers Place, I think, so. But there's a bunch, there's gonna be even more. I hope that I helped explain that in any fucking way possible to make it easier. I really do, because I think it's important for you to understand just our future, like everybody, if you're into art or not. Like, I think it's, you know, cryptocurrency, this is the same thing cryptocurrency lives on, and currency is only one aspect of this. So to not think about artifacts and items and collectibles is just, I think, short-sighted. So that's my spiel on NFTs and Chainlink, or not Chainlink, that's a whole other conversation, but that's my spiel on NFTs. Hopefully you understand it more. If not, I'm sorry. You could try to hit me up. I'll try to explain it better, but I might not even be the best guy. You know, there's plenty of people who've had to help explain it to me this week. But with that being said, today, my phone's ringing. Hold on. Hello. Not interested. The only other thing I'm going to do today is avoid all of the people posting Bernie Sanders sitting in random places. Look, I'm going to get into it on the podcast, but if you want to celebrate your own oppression and the fact that you have an illusion of choice by just making fun of yourself and everything, the entire, like, I can't listen to you harp about your political opinions with rage and the downfall of Western society, you know, every other day of the week, and now we're just gonna copy and paste Bernie Sanders into any situation where he's sitting, because sitting is entertaining to us now. You know, sitting, we are fucking half a step away from fucking idiocracy. Like, y'all are basically watching ass right now. I don't understand. We're going on a hike. It's not like a real hike. I don't do hikes at least I don't think it's a real hike. I guess we'll find out. I don't really know. But apparently, there's some hieroglyphics. That's all I know, is that we're searching for hieroglyphics. This is the fucking craziness that we're doing right now. You know what I'm saying? We're talking about future of the world, digital revolution of everything that you know, and also hiking outside in the elements to see hieroglyphics, or emojis of the yesteryear, as I like to call them. Hieroglyphics are just emojis. Don't get it twisted.
Climb this one. It's kind of a stair set right here.
The first dick pic ever. I mean, it's the first thing I would have done.